Sometimes it's impractical to create separate classes every time you want to make a change. If we've taken the time to create the most glorious heading on the planet, and we want to use that class as a starting point for a variation, if we want the same thing somewhere else but in light blue, we could create a new class and go through the entire process again, or we can use a combo class. We'll cover three aspects of combo classes: creating a combo class, overriding styles, and selecting the base class. Let's create a combo class, and we'll work with this button. There are a lot of buttons on this page, all of them completely unstyled. And what we'll do is click to type in and create a class, since we intend to reuse this styling. And we can go in and make changes, like setting a background color on this class, or going in under typography and setting a font color. And we might want to change the default padding on the button, so we can make adjustments there, clicking and dragging while holding Option or Alt to affect opposing sides of the button at the same time. And finally, let's round things out by going down to the radius. Add some rounding on the corners. Now, we already named this class, so we can go through and apply it to some of the other unstyled buttons on the page. We're simply selecting each of these buttons and applying the class we just created to each of them. But wait a second. This section, when we apply our class to the button, doesn't have the greatest contrast. We could remove the class and try and remember all those changes, creating a new class from scratch, or we can create a combo class. We're going to click in the blank space to the right of the base class, the one we created before, and type to create our combo class. And of course, hit enter. And it's worth noting that a combo class, just like a regular class, is applying directly to the element. So if we check out any of the other buttons, nothing's changed. But with our button down here, once we've created a combo class, we can add or override styles without affecting the original class. That leads us to the next step, overriding styles. Because our selector field has the combo class showing up here, any styles we add or override will only affect the combo class. Let's check out these indicators. We can see that our background color and our font color, all the style values we added before, they're all coming from the base class we created earlier. Let's change that. We'll adjust our background color. We can go in and change that value. And we'll go in and do the same thing, this time making a change to the font color. Of course, each of these changes has turned the orange indicator blue. We know that means the currently selected class, our combo class, has its own styles that are now being set. Now, those pre-existing style changes aren't necessary. You can add new styles to a combo class that weren't explicitly set in our base class, like all caps. But that's how we override and add styles on a combo class. Let's talk about the base class. Again, because we're styling the combo class, these style changes aren't affecting our base class. That's because the combo class is a more specific selection. But let's select one of the original buttons and make a change to the font size. Notice how doing that affects the button that has the combo class applied. That's because we didn't override the font size. If we click in and take a look at our orange indicator, we can see that the font size, that change, is being inherited from our base class. We can also select the base class from our selector field. Simply click the dropdown and select the base class. Even though our newer button still has that combo class applied, we're currently styling the base class. Changing the font here will affect our base class everywhere. We can switch back to styling our combo class by simply pressing go back. And if we check our font here in the combo class, we can see it's being inherited right from the base class we just modified. So, combo classes save us a ton of time. We can create combo classes, which inherit the styling from our base class. We can override or add our own styles, but we can still go in and select the base class to make changes at any time.